You know, like I said in so many other reviews, the longer I'm here, the worse it gets. It gets worse and worse every time. Candyman 3, Day of the Dead, stars Tony Todd as Daniel Robitaille, aka Candyman. Donna Errico, I think that's her name. She plays Caroline McKeever, but she's a distant relative of Candyman, aka Daniel Robitaille. I'm not going to get into who he was. Watch the other two movies if you want to know. It opens up with a museum, and Caroline is friends with some dude named Miguel. And Miguel's like, will you please let me promote my museum by using your family history? And she agrees to do it. So he convinces everybody at the museum that Candyman is back. And of course, by doing that, Candyman does indeed come back. This movie was very unique. Had a lot of racism in it. They had a cop that was racist. His name was Detective Samuel Deacon Kraft. He's played by Wade Williams. Long story short, Candyman comes back and he starts haunting Caroline. And he says, we can be immortal. We can live forever. Our names will be whispered on the lips of the faithful. And it will be whispered throughout my congregation. Okay. If Candyman has a loyal congregation, why does he kill them? Why do you kill your followers? If you kill all of your followers, you won't have any more left, you moron. What kind of movie is this? I don't understand this franchise at all. He says things like, be my victim. How about hell no? Why would I let you kill me? Why? It doesn't make any sense. Be my victim? That's the dumbest catchphrase I ever heard. If I let you kill me, I'm gonna be dead. Why would I let you do that? And then he's like, oh, you can be whispered on the lips of the faithful. They'll remember you forever. But I'll still be dead. What good is them remembering me when I can be there in the flesh? He says retarded stuff. He comes back and he kills all of Caroline's friends to convince her that he's real. Finally, she's convinced, but not before all her friends are telling her, you're crazy, there's no such thing as the Candyman. And they have this weird festival going on, Day of the Dead. What kinds of things go on in these towns? First, they had some kind of thing called Farewell to the Flesh, and that was in the second one. And, you know, they had that written somewhere. This franchise is very strange. Basically, he's butthurt. That's putting it in a language that the modern people can understand. Daniel Robitaille is butthurt because he was murdered by white people. And I guess that's a reason to be angry. But bro, you can't go on like this forever. You're dead. Get over it. He was so butthurt that he got mad and came back to life. That's the whole story in a nutshell. He's like, oh, they killed me because I was dating a white woman. What did you expect? You were in the 1800s, you moron. The film itself wasn't bad. I kind of liked it. It was unique. And I liked the song at the end of it. A very unique music score. Caroline goes to this healer, and the healer tells her that good can't exist without evil. You have to destroy the good and the evil that he did. You have to destroy the paintings. And you have to destroy the myth and the legend of Candyman. Of course, as you all know, you say his name 5 times and he appears. You all know that, so I don't have to get into that. but it's really not much to say about this movie. The cop is racist, like I said, he hates anybody who isn't white. He makes fun of the Hispanics, makes fun of the blacks, and now he hates Caroline McKeever because she sympathizes with minorities. So he tries to frame her for the Candyman murders. And he also tries to frame the Hispanic guy. No surprise there. But then Candyman kidnaps Miguel's friend. And he's like, I'll give him back if you give your life to me. That's what he tells Caroline. Give your life to me and I'll give him back. Your life for his. You're telling me I can be a ghost with you, or I can live in the real world in the flesh. Now let's balance that out on a scale. Be a ghost or be an actual person. Which one do you think I'm going to pick? He's like one of the worst villains ever because he has retarded lines. Candyman kills all her friends. Then he tries to get to her. She destroys the painting and he disappears. And then she lies to the police and tells the police that the racist cop was in fact the Candyman. And the murders were blamed on him, thus making the myth of Candyman useless. That's it. Because Candyman is believed to be just a story, nobody believes in him anymore. He's non-existent. He's dead. And they're having lunch at somebody's grave. That's really sick. But they claim it's part of their tradition in the Hispanic culture. I'm not dissing the Hispanics, but that's crazy. I'm not having lunch in a cemetery. That's gross. Sorry. I mean, I have Hispanic people in my family. I'm pretty sure they wouldn't go along with that, but whatever. But Candyman is dead. For good, at least for now. I didn't get too specific with this movie, but it was stupid. What do you want me to say? Having them stupid lines, be my victim. Wow, okay. And it says here that Tony Todd said that this was his least favorite film in the franchise. There were only three of the movies, so how could you say that? There's only three of them in the first place. Candyman 3, ladies and gentlemen, take it for what it's worth. He was butthurt because he was killed by white people. Hey, I understand that, but, you know, that don't give you the reason to, you know, that doesn't give you a motive and a reason to kill people. But according to this movie, if you're killed, you can come back through a mirror and kill the people that killed you. I don't know. I don't understand why he would be so angry anyway. Falling in love with a white person was taboo at that time anyway. So why would he be angry? What else would he expect? It was the 1800s. I keep saying that. That's what I don't get about this movie. They're saying, oh, poor Candyman. He was killed because he fell in love with the white lady. Well, it was the 1800s. That's what they did back then. You can't do that. You couldn't go outside of your race back then. Of course they were going to kill him. It was the normal thing to do. Normally, I would say, is that what we do in the hood? But apparently, yeah, back in the 1800s. Like I said, you could take it for what it's worth. Candyman 3, Day of the Dead. That's about it. They said that there was supposed to be a sequel, but I don't see anything about that. I'm the Michael Myers fanatic. I approve this message. Candyman 3, Day of the Dead, November 30th, 1999, straight to DVD. I'm out. Apparently, if you get killed by white people, that gives you the excuse to come back and kill your descendants or whatever. I don't know. I gotta go. I'm out. Peace.